Good evening, PSJA families. Thank you for joining us today as we award the 2021 PSJA Education Foundation Scholarships. My name is Carlos Garcia, and I will be today's Master of Ceremonies. Please help me welcome special guests joining us this evening. From our school board members, President Jorge Zambrano. Vice President Jesus Jesse Vela. Member Carlos Villegas Jr. Member Jesse Zambrano. From our superintendent's cabinet, Dr. Rolando Rudy Treviño, Chief Academic Officer. Estroberto Nick Martinez, Chief Operation Officer. From our senior staff, Dr. Lauro Davalos, Assistant Superintendent for Technology. Ms. Claudia Gonzalez, Executive Officer for Elementary Schools. Ms. Linda Uribe, Executive Officer for College Readiness. From our PSJISD Education Foundation, President Jesse Vela Jr. Vice President Ms. Marlene Lopez. Member Veronica Bernal McCann. Member Jorge Zambrano. Member Jorge George Palacios. Member Mike Cano. Member Judge Jerry Munoz. Thank you for your support and dedication to the PSJA students. And now, please help me welcome our PSJA Education Foundation President, Mr. Jesse Vela Jr., for some opening remarks.
Thank you, Carlos, and again, welcome to all of you today for this special event. The Education Foundation has been in existence as a foundation, as a 501c3 now for 9 years, and so we've been giving scholarships longer than that. It used to be called the Education Business Coalition, and we raised money as a business coalition. It was a smaller scale program, maybe raising $30,000 a year, $35,000 a year, which obviously we couldn't give too many scholarships with that amount of money. So along the way, at approximately, was it about 2011, 2012, around that time, Dr. King, or before, maybe before, the idea was conceptualized that perhaps we need to incorporate as a 501c3, which gave us a lot of leverage, meaning that we could leverage more money, more funding, if you will, and reach out to the business communities, corporate America, other individuals, other nonprofits, philanthropics, all those individuals that obviously donate money for worthy causes. And of course, one of the most worthy causes was to give scholarships to our deserving students as much as we possibly could. So over the course of the last 9 years, I know we've raised well over $2 million. I know we have in that range. And we've given all of it practically back in the form of scholarships to students, teacher mini grants for creative teachers to submit creative ideas so they can get funding in their classrooms, ideas for technology advances, innovative things in the area of T-STEM or STEM technology, math, science, etc., and obviously supporting our library services, literacy, all those programs the foundation supports. And we give well over $400,000, $450,000 back every single year. I would remiss if I don't mention the fact that our teachers in our district make contributions by way of monthly deductions or one-time donations, and we've been doing this from the very beginning. And they're very generous in helping us to raise the money to help to give it back to all of you. And we've been doing this now for many years, as a foundation at least 9 years. So we're very proud of that, and we've established a history and a legacy of doing this. So tonight, just as an example, and I was tabulating the numbers, we will give out 153 scholarships this evening worth $332,000. Thank you. And we owe it to our great partners, the generosity of many, many people in our districts, in our community, all over this area. So I truly appreciate that. Let me introduce two major scholarships that are going to be given out to some of you. We're going to give out 5 Joey Gonzalez Presidential Scholarships and 4 Dr. King, Daniel P. King Leadership Scholarships that are worth quite a bit of money. And they're already in the book, and you probably already know who you are. That's okay. But I need to give credit, because when Dr. King was here, he helped spearhead the formation of the 501c3, and that was done 2009, 10, around that time. Just before I got on the school board, it became a foundation, and then I became an immediate member as a member of the school board in 2012. So the idea grew, and it picked up, and it was finalized, and it took a little bit of time. But again, it leverages. So it was while Dr. King was here that it was created. And I thank Dr. King. Thank you for doing that, because otherwise we would be kind of stuck still having golf tournaments, which is nothing wrong with, but we would not raise the number of funds that we are raising today, okay? And Dr. King is here as a special invitee, because we will give out 4 Dr. Daniel P. King Leadership Scholarships worth $10,000. $2,500 per year for 4 years. The other scholarship is the Joey Gonzalez Presidential Scholarship. And the board made a decision to name a scholarship in his honor, in his name. If you don't know Joey Gonzalez, like I know him, and many of you may know him, those of us that have been around a few years, Joey Gonzalez was an outstanding student at PSJA, valedictorian of his class, all-state football player, incredible human being. But beyond all of that, Joey was an incredible servant. He gave back to his community. He was our first president of the foundation. He passed away unexpectedly at such a young age. He was taken from us so at such a young age. And unfortunately, we created a scholarship in his honor. So whoever receives that honor, you're going to carry the weight of Joey Gonzalez. Scholar, athlete, and a public servant. He gave back, and a very unselfish human being. And we have his daughter here, Jenna, representing Joey Gonzalez. Jenna, please stand up. And I'll have to introduce her husband, Scott. Scott, stand up, please. He's a member of the family now. Please, Scott. I wanted to say these words because it's very important. And there's a reason why we do what we do. We're riding on the shoulders of people like Joey Gonzalez and others like Joey Gonzalez. And thanks to the vision and the tenacity, the hard work of many, many people just to raise money. One of the hardest things to do is to raise funds, by the way. Some people make it look easy, but it's hard. This past year, for 15 months, it was tough to ask people for money. And I think you know why. You know, businesses closing down, stuff happening, letting go of staff, letting go of people, losing their jobs. That was the year we had. But you know what? We came out at the other end, and there's a lot of daylight, a lot of daylight for all of you. I better stop because I don't want to keep you here longer because someone's going to the prom. I know that. So let's move on now to when these scholarships are introduced. I gave you the heading. I gave you the reasoning why and who they are, these people, who they are, and the significance of who they are to the foundation and to their communities. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Vela. And now we will hear from our PSJA ISD School Board President and Foundation member, Mr. Jorge Zambrano.
Good evening, students, parents, and invited guests. Thank you for joining us today as we award our PSJA ISD Class of 2021 with PSJA Education Foundation Scholarships. I want to thank the members of our foundation, our local businesses, and other donors for their contributions that help us fund these awards. On behalf of our school board, I thank you for keeping the future of our students in mind. Parents, congratulations. We hope these scholarships help fund your child's post-secondary dreams. Congratulations. And on behalf of the PSJA School Board, may God bless PSJA. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Zambrano. Addressing you today with a special remark from our school district on behalf of our superintendent of schools, Dr. Jorge Luis Arredondo, is Chief Academic Officer, Dr. Rolando Rudy Treviño.
Buenas noches. Good evening to you all. I have to begin by saying thank you to the foundation board members and everyone that contributes to the foundation. Thank you so much. Your generosity is truly appreciated. I bring you greetings on behalf of Dr. Jorge Arredondo. He couldn't be here today, but I wanted to just simply say a few words both to everyone that contributes to the foundation and makes these scholarships possible, as well as our school board members that are here as well, and our board president, as he was introduced earlier, Trustee Zambrano, Jorge Zambrano, our board president. I want to speak mostly to the students. And I will be brief myself, but I have three main points I want to make before I conclude my remarks. First of all, congratulations. You have done some remarkable things, some outstanding things to get to where you are today, and you should be commended for that. In some way, there is a group of individuals that have been working tirelessly to help you be recognized for that. Second point is I'm going to speak on their behalf, con su permiso, and say the only thing we really ask in return is that you go do some extraordinary things, that you make us all proud, that the tradition and the culture of the Education Foundation can be celebrated through your accomplishments. In other words, in investment words, make sure that we get a really good return on our investment, because these individuals have collectively contributed their time, their finances, and their interest in helping make sure you receive some scholarships. And the third, perhaps most important point is, find a way at some point in your life. It doesn't necessarily have to be at the fifth year after you get your bachelor's degree. It doesn't have to be at the ninth year when you get your master's degree. Or like some of us, it doesn't have to be at the 12th or 10th year after you get your doctorate. But at some point in your life, find a way to come back to the Tri-City community and give back. Many of the individuals that are part of the foundation right now have been part of being alums. So are you. The only request we have is do extraordinary things and find a way to give back. You don't have to give back with money, but your time and service and your true servant leadership to our Tri-City community could pretty much exemplify what the whole purpose of a nonprofit like this is all about. Again, I can't thank the members. We have different people that contribute differently, from banks to partners to individual funders to law firms, you name it, individuals that contribute so that you can have the level of success you have. Go out and make us proud, and thank you to each and every one of you, and thanks to the staff that's here. Thank you all. Y'all have a good evening.
Thank you, Dr. Treviño. We will now start awarding the scholarships. If I can please have North line up to my right. We'll begin with PSJ North Early College High School $1,000 scholarship recipients. These are the recipients for the $1,000 scholarship. Caleb Galvan. Jose Gonzalez. Alexis Palomín. Aisa de la Garza. Andrea Salinas. Audrey Villegas, and Mr. Villegas will be receiving her award on her behalf. Maximus Quintana. Miriam Lopez. Anissa Barrera. Kayla Montemayor. Destiny Escobar. Celeste Díaz. Now to present the PSJA North Recurring Four-Year Scholarship is Foundation Vice President, Mrs. Marlene Lopez.
Now for the four-year $1,500 renewable scholarship, Stephanie Quintanilla. Melanie Mendez Rangel. Josué López. And now for the Dr. Daniel P. King Leadership Scholarship, the four-year renewable scholarship for $2,500. Alexander Guerra. And now for the Joel Joey Gonzalez 2021 Presidential Four-Year $4,000 Scholarship, Jennifer Bernal.
We have two more $1,000 scholarship recipients. We have Mr. Daniel Garza. Kalina Sanchez. And now Mr. Vela will present the award for the Mario Alejo Cantú Jr. Community Scholarship.
Thank you. Where's my information? Where's my information though?
This is.
You got all my stuff. I don't have a name.
No, this is mine.
Okay.
This
Sorry, I have to find my notes. This next scholarship is the Mario Cantu Scholarship. And Mario Cantu is a young man also that unfortunately passed away very young. Mario passed away from a heart attack at a very young age. And his family members, Ronnie Cantu in particular, Eddie Cantu, and other family members got together and named the scholarship in his honor. And it's dedicated to him and his history of service. This is the Mario Alejo Cantu Jr. Community Scholarship in the amount of $1,000. And the recipient of this scholarship is Alexa Flores. Congratulations, Alexa. Your record of service is just incredible. And Mario would be proud of you. Congratulations. This is
Thank
your certificate.
You.
Okay, with honor.
We have another PSJA North, $1,000 scholarship. Victor Gomez. Thank you. Now we will present the $1,000 scholarship for PSJ Memorial Early College High School. If you can line up to the right, please. Receiving the $1,000 scholarship for PSJ Memorial Early College High School, we have Ana Villacana. Congratulations. Karen Carrasco. Daniel Martinez. Karime Marroquín. Olga Ibarra. Heidi Gonzalez. Nadaline Morales. Maria Ramos Sanchez. José Martínez Pruneda. Victoria Hetheridge. Annalie Mora. Alexandra Cordero. Kelly Gonzalez. Manuel Ramirez III. Kayla Guajardo. Melody Garza. Juan Cisneros. And now Foundation member Ms. Veronica Bernal McCann will now present the top scholarships for PSJA Memorial.
Buenas tardes, padres de familia, estudiantes y invitados especiales. Queríamos darle una bienvenida a este lugar y a esta presentación. Como ya se anunció, nosotros somos producto y fruto de PSJA y es nuestro deseo, yo sé de que cada uno de nosotros, de que nuestros estudiantes regresen a cultivar lo que ya se empezó y también den fruto para que el día de mañana ellos estén aquí parados como nosotros dando estas presentaciones. Muchísimas gracias por estar aquí después de una semana laboral. Now for the four-year $1,500 scholarship, Fernanda López. Melissa Garza Bustillos. Alexis Martinez. Now for our Dr. Daniel Paul King Leadership Scholarship, Jennifer Alvarez. And now for our presidential Joey Gonzalez four-year scholarship, Natalie Acha.
Thank you, Ms. Bernal McCann. And now Mr. Vela will present the award for the Bracamontes Second Chance Scholarship, joined by Mr. Mario Bracamontes.
We're awarding the Bracamontes Second Chance $1,000 scholarship. In a few minutes, I'll announce the winner. Just a few words about the second chance. It means exactly what it says, a second chance. It's for students who, for whatever reasons, encountered some difficult circumstances, and maybe they made some bad choices or choices that were not to their benefit. Or perhaps they were having difficulties in school, both either academics or otherwise. In general, these students persevered. They came back. They were given a second chance. So nice, thanks to the generosity of Mario Bracamontes and his family, they've raised funds and they created a second chance scholarship for outstanding students who came back, and against odds, they overcame a lot of obstacles. So the recipient of this year's Bracamontes Second Chance Scholarship is Gia J. Magana. Accepting the award this evening is Mrs. Rekay from Sotomayor School. So on her behalf, she will be accepting it. Thank you very much, Mrs. Rekay.
Thank you, Mr. Mario Bracamontes. And now we will present the $1,000 scholarship for PSJA Southwest Early College High School. Jimena Rocha. Nicholas Reina. Isa Garza. Alicia Alvarado. Jair Martinez. Sherlyn Perez. Samira Garcia. Andres Mejia. Melissa Castro. Lauren Reyes. Erica Arona. Alexandra Valles. Foundation member Judge Jaime Jerry Munoz will now present the top scholarships for PSJ Southwest.
Okay, well, good evening, everybody. Before I mention the names, I do want to take a minute. I know we're recognizing the students and providing scholarships for them tonight, but tonight's ceremony is a product of your dedication and sacrifice for these students. And I want to recognize the parents for that tonight. Congratulations to each and every one of you. Starting off with the four-year $1,500 scholarship, Christopher Nicanor. Mario Torres. Carlos Hernández Treviño. Okay, moving on to the next scholarship. We have the Dr. Daniel P. King Leadership Scholarship. This is a four-year, $2,500 scholarship. This year's recipient is Ms. Marianne Leal. The next scholarship is the Joel Joey Gonzalez Scholarship. This is the 2021 presidential four-year, $4,000 scholarship, and that is being awarded to Miss Sofia Leal Cavazos.
We have another $1,000 scholarship for PSJ Southwest, America Montano. And now Mr. Vela will present the award for the Noah A. Robles Memorial Scholarship.
Well, I get these certificates before I announce the scholarship recipients. I want to ask those of you that are getting the Dr. King Scholarship and those that are getting the Joey Gonzalez Scholarship, if you can stay back, because we're going to take a photo up with the five of you that are getting Joey Gonzalez, and then the four of you that are getting the Dr. King. We'll do one independently and then one combined. So if you're good with that, please stay back so we can take that photo up. Please, I appreciate it very much. The next scholarship that we're going to present was a scholarship named in honor of Noah A. Robles. And this is a young man who also passed very young. And thanks to the generosity of a family member as well as an independent company where he works, and then the Education Foundation also matched the contribution to initiate the Noah Robles Memorial Scholarship Fund. This is for an individual who is involved in Future Farmers of America, all things FFA related to that field, and or be in the swimming program, been a swimmer for X amount of years throughout the course of a high school career. Either or both. In this case, I think most of the applicants came from the area of FFA, which Noah was excellent at doing and participating. He was an excellent swimmer as well. He was a good athlete, and he was also involved in leadership development, leadership skills in Future Farmers of America. So we have two recipients for this award in the amount of $1,000. The first one is Marianne Leal. Our second recipient of the Noah A. Robles Memorial Scholarship is Julissa Lopez.
Thank you, Mr. Vela. And now we will present the $1,000 scholarships for PSJA Early College High School. We have Daniela Moya. Iris Ambule. Matthew Salinas. Mariana Salinas. Jason García. Ellie Alemán. José Fiscal. José Rodríguez. Melinda Lee Pruneda. Tania Martínez. Aliyah Díaz. Gavin García. Ashley Hernández. Michael de Santiago. Emmanuel Vela. Carol Elizondo. Isaiah Casas. Melanie Garza. Emma Ponce. Gustavo Garza. Foundation member Mr. Jorge Zambrano will now present the top scholarships for PSJA Early College High School.
Four-year, $1,500 scholarship awarded to Julissa Lopez. Four-year, $1,500 scholarship awarded to Crystal Torres. Four-year, $1,500 scholarship awarded to Ana Elizondo. And now, the Dr. Daniel P. King Leadership Scholarship, four-year, $2,500 scholarship awarded to Alexa Flores. And now, to introduce the Guzman Athletic Scholarship, board member Jesse Zambrano.
Good evening. I also want to thank the parents and the students for your hard work and sacrifice to getting here today and being awarded these scholarships. As everybody mentioned today, these are donations by community members for your education, and so we want to commend you for everything that you all have done to earn the scholarships. Just a few words on the Coach Guzman scholarship. A few years ago, we wanted to make a donation to the foundation as we were raising funds for that year's gala. And we thought about, or I thought about honoring my high school football coach for everything that he did for me when I was an athlete here at PSJ High School. And so in his honor, we decided to make a $10,000 contribution, $1,000 scholarships, and I believe that this is the fifth or the sixth scholarship already that we have awarded. And so the recipient for the Roy Guzman Athletic Scholarship is supposed to be a student athlete that wants to pursue a career either in law or in business, and the recipient is Samantha Vasquez.
The next scholarship is the Jesse and Jorge Zambrano Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a student who has shown immense interest in the legal field through the PSJA Pre-Law Institute since we started the program. Congratulations to Jacob Benavides.
Thank you, Mr. Zambrano. And now Mr. George Palacios will present the award for the PSJA AIM High Scholarship.
All right, good evening. Okay, it's my honor to announce the $1,000 two-year scholarship for Andrew N. Moreno.
Thank you, Mr. Palacios. And now we will present the $1,000 scholarship recipients for PSJA TSTEM Early College High School. If I can have TSTEM on the side, please. We will start with the $1,000 scholarship recipient from PSJA TSTEM, Benjamin Martinez. Emmanuel Ramirez. Marisol Sagastegui. Ann Perez. Valeria González. Kareli Zárate. Darina Lopez. Grecia Arevalo. Bianca Mora. Aisha Guijarro. Janelle Perez. Shaylee Kobaxin. Aaron Medrano. Gabriela Torres García. Alessandra Rosales. And now Mr. George Palacios will present the top awards for PSJ T-STEM.
It's my honor to announce four-year, $1,500 scholarship, Yaritza Gutierrez. And another four-year, $1,500 scholarship for Janessa Torres. All right, and now our Joel Joey Gonzalez, 2021 Presidential four-year, $4,000 scholarship. Diana Gonzalez.
Want to announce it right now?
Yes.
Okay. So I just do this. Right? Okay. Do I do this one first or this one first? Doesn't matter. Huh? Okay.
All right. We also have with the AIM High Scholarship, Ariana Flores. Congratulations. And from our PSJA Sotomayor High School, $1,000 scholarship for Isalma Torres. That was my fault. And from PSJA, Elvis Ballou, CCTA, $1,000 scholarship, Natalia Barcenas. From Ballou High School, CCTA, $1,000 scholarship, Monica Ocañas. Congratulations. And from our PSJA AIM High, two-year, $1,000 scholarship recipient, Samuel Diaz.
Thank you, Mr. Palacios. Congratulations again to all of today's recipients. On behalf of the entire PSJA Education Foundation and PSJA ISD, we congratulate you and wish you the very best in college and beyond. Remember, our college transition team is here for you. You are not alone, so whenever you need assistance while in college, just let us know. Have a great night. Que pasen buenas noches.